Ihr findet das ja wahrscheinlich alle völlig normal, mit großen Datenmengen umzugehen. So Typen wie ich, die herkömmliche Journalisten sind, ich bin im Hauptberuf Hörfunkjournalist, die verzweifeln regelmäßig daran. Also wir haben gelernt, damals Leute zu fragen, die sich mit irgendwas auskennen. Jetzt ist Leute fragen, die sich mit großen Datenmengen auskennen, auch nicht unbedingt zielführend für unser einen. Dafür gibt es aber neuerdings einen relativ frischen Beruf. Dieser Beruf nennt sich Datenjournalist. Datenjournalisten sind diese Menschen, die aus aberwitzig großen Datenmengen Zusammenhänge rauspopeln und diese Zusammenhänge dann idealerweise auch noch so visualisieren, dass solche Noobs wie ich das dann auch verstehen und hinterher kompetent drüber reden können oder jedenfalls so aussehen können, als würden sie kompetent drüber reden. Und einer, der so Leute wie uns sehr dabei unterstützt, ist Datenjournalist. Das ist nämlich der Michael Kreil und seinen Vortrag seht ihr jetzt. Viel Spaß.
Guten Morgen. Ihr habt gut geschlafen. Ich nicht, weil erstens halte ich jetzt einen Vortrag vor vielen Leuten.
First of all, I'm going to give a talk in front of a lot of people.
Das zu sehr hitzigen Debatten und Shitstorms geführt hat.
And I'm going to talk about a subject that's led to a lot of heated debates.
Erste Folie, and Disclaimer.
Therefore, I don't want to stand front and center. Here's my disclaimer.
Ich distanziere mich hiermit ausdrücklich gegen jegliche Form von Rassismus, Sexismus, Antisemitismus, Fremdenfeindlichkeit, Islamfeindlichkeit,
allgemein
gegen jede Form von gruppenbezogener Menschlichkeit,
all racism, sexism, antisemitism, xenophobia, Islamophobia and
in general, im Rahmen dieses Vortrages bin ich Wissenschaftler und Beobachter einer hitzigen Gesellschaftsdebatte und sehe mich so mit der Neutralität verpflichtet,
die Debatte beobachten und
nicht Teil von ihr sein.
Es geht also nicht um meine politische Position,
sondern um eine neutrale Analyse von Daten.
Und dafür habe ich mal 150 Folien vorbereitet.
Ich habe
für this data analysis I've prepared 150
genau.
Slides.
Dann lass uns direkt reinschmeißen.
So,
das erste ist die Methodik, das ich gerne noch mal vorher erzählen,
like
damit die Leute auch wissen, wie es funktioniert und
so people know how all of this works and to ensure that it's reproducible. Twitter has an API that lets you request status, tweets, users, what lists have been published, you can look at them. Followers. And then you write an interface for this API. If you put in a bit of effort, you're going to put a cache in between as well. And if you make a massive effort and invest some days or weeks, you scale the whole thing so that you no longer have just one interface, but lots of them, and each of them represents a single Twitter user. So I'm not just calling the Twitter API as a single user, but as lots of users. And on top of that is a load balancer that balances the load. Because the Twitter API is limited. If I want to know who follows whom, I can only make a certain number of requests at a time. But if lots of people have given me their authorization to make requests, that means, of course, I can make more requests at the same time. This is a kind of democratic process in which people can support me to cause more load on the Twitter API. My colleague Jetzt has built this interface where you can donate a token and you click this, and when you do that we get a long code that allows us to send additional requests to the API of Twitter. Thank you also to Logbuch Netzpolitik, especially Tim and Linus and the 700 donors who gave us their token, which was necessary to pull large amounts of data out of Twitter.
Schon bei mir zu Hause kann ich dann über Kabel Deutschland 10 Requests pro Sekunde abwälzen.
So even at home I can use Kabel Deutschland to make 10 requests per second, and if I want to get the metadata of all 330 million Twitter accounts, that would take me about 4 days, Without tokens, you'd be looking at months or even years.
Funktioniert im Prinzip auch sehr stark auf Twitter fokussiert die Analysen.
That means that my entire analysis was focused mainly on Twitter, of course.
Fake News ist ein komplexes Thema.
Fake News is a complex subject. I took this graphic from the Stiftung Neue Verantwortung, who made this characterizations of what constitutes fake news and what does not. On the left side is poor politics, which is not fake news. Satire is not fake news. Poor journalism, clickbaiting.
Sollen eigentlich nicht zu Fake News gezählt werden. Fake News sein oder sind gezielte Desinformationen.
Articles are factually wrong, are not fake news. Fake news is targeted disinformation, manipulated content, where images, for instance, are cropped in a certain way, or content that is simply made up. Unfortunately, I only have an hour for this, so I can't look at several fake news waves, which means that I will look at one that impressed me a lot. This was this is a tweet from the AfD Magdeburg, who said that the German Foreign Office had issued a travel warning for Sweden, which is of course not based on any kind of fact. And hours or days later, the German Foreign Office sent out this tweet where they denied that they had issued this travel warning. There were posted almost 2,000 tweets on this subject, and I can use this Twitter framework to analyze them and to think of some visualizations. Here's one I made. This is a timeline. It spans from the 2nd of March 2017 until the 9th of March 2017, so 1 week. And on top of those are those who published the actual fake news, and on the bottom are those who published the counter news. And retweets are visualized by these arcs that span across the top or bottom of the timeline. So this allows me to visualize the impact of a certain tweet. So if lots of people retweeted a tweet, you'll see a lot of arcs. The first tweet on this subject was published at the end of September, but it had no impact whatsoever, no favorites, no tweets. In February, there was another tweet on this from an account with just one follower, and it did not get any retweets. So these topics came up before, but they weren't carried into a larger debate.
So jetzt gehen wir mal rüber zu unserem Zeitstrahl.
Let's da gibt's dann den look at our timeline. The first person who tweets about this is a screenshot from a bot that publishes travel warnings. It got 6 retweets and 6 favs, and that was the first small impact.
Dann steigert es sich immer mehr, dann gibt es die Reisewarnung für Schweden.
And this grows and grows, and we get this travel warning for Sweden with 29 retweets. I can't show you the next tweet because the account has been blocked in the meantime. This is a phenomenon that we saw quite often. Trump was right, the Foreign Office issues a travel warning for Sweden.
Und verweist auf einen Artikel von zuerst.de.
And it links to an article from zuerst.de.
Und es steigert sich immer mehr.
And it just
ist noch doch nicht alles ruhig in Schweden.
Keeps growing. Apparently not all is quiet in Sweden.
Islamterror.
Islamic terror.
Und dann zum Schluss die AfD Magdeburg.
And finally the AfD party in Magdeburg. That jumps on the bandwagon and adds their own hashtag, and
it,
you see this crescendo of where we get from a travel warning to Islamic terrorism.
And
people countering this news started with the German Foreign Office. and then the German media jump on the bandwagon who published this. And if you look at the entire timeline, it's interesting to note that this was not just published as fake news and everybody was really really upset, but it's more of a stutter. It looks like people were experimenting, and we saw a lot of network resonance. And I would say that fake news are a meme that transmit in that grow in this network. The core phenomenon of fake news is not their existence, but the fact that they can spread so well. It's not the source that creates them, but it's the resonance they find in a network. So if you were to ban fake news sources, they would still spread in the network. And because fake news as a meme have a large reach, you can draw capital from them. And I'd like to mention Breitband News from the United States, who get a lot of political capital from this in the United States.
Zeitlichen Verlauf sich anschauen, sagen wir,
we're looking at the timeline again. We're looking at which accounts are actually going against the fake news and
die sich gegenseitig folgen. Und daraus baut man dann
how they're followed to spread this message against the fake news.
Die blauen sind die Gegendarstellungsverbreiter.
The blue are the ones that are against the fake news.
Umso näher sie grafisch dargestellt werden, umso
and the closer the accounts, the stronger the blue is, the more the accounts are linked together. And then we can analyze how complex the network is. The interesting thing is
fast außerhalb befinden und eigentlich nur noch über die Massenmedien.
That the ones that are spread further apart are actually not part of the core news teams.
Man sieht natürlich auch noch Tendenzen, dass viele Fake News Verbreiter dann mit Lügenpresse und so weiter versuchen.
And we see that actually the fake news is being spread by the lying press or the Lügenpresse.
Gruppen, die man hier sehen kann. Und das erste Mal, als ich das Bild gesehen habe, habe ich
the first time I saw this, this picture, I thought this must be a mistake.
Das Schöne ist, weil wir mit Twitter APIs tiefer in die
Daten. But the good thing is, because we're working with Twitter APIs,
die Timeline rekonstruieren.
We can actually reconstruct the timeline from that.
Schematisch dargestellt, die
here we're representing a schematic of the tweets.
Fake News Verbreitern 89% die Gegendarstellung mitbekommen haben, aber sie nicht weiter teilen.
From the fake news, 89%
derjenigen, die Gegendarstellung verbreitet haben, haben tatsächlich ursprüngliche Fake News eigentlich mitbekommen.
Okay, so 89% of those that spread the fake news actually saw the other side, but only 43% of those that spread the other side saw the fake news. So what we can see is that there is a filter bubble.
Ich habe ein schwieriges Geschütz aufgefahren und habe 1,6 Millionen Twitter Accounts.
So what I did is
Deutsch sprechen.
I extracted 1.6 million Twitter accounts
das gesamte deutschsprachige Twitter-Netzwerk
and tried to represent the entire German-speaking Twitter network. There's Switzerland and Austria and the rest of it is all throughout Germany.
Das ist so ein Tool, was ich gebastelt habe. Man kann das unterschiedlich einfärben. Hier kann man zum Beispiel mal
and you can use different colors to color this.
Rot sind die alten, grün sind die
so here you can, this one is red are old accounts, green are new, younger accounts.
Hier haben wir eine
so green is a lot of youth and YouTube.
Nicht there's
a bubble with porn, please don't click
it. Haben wir eine Gruppe, die sich mit Marketing
then on the left side there's a group that is marketing stuff.
Und keine Ahnung was. Und das sind die Leute, die sich eigentlich mit Politik
and on the left right on the left bottom, there's people that are interested in politics and media, and those are probably the ones that we're interested in at this point. We can also use different colors.
Bundestagsabgeordneten oder Kandidaten von Parteien, wo sich in diesem Netzwerk befinden.
Now we'll look at which party candidates are where in this network.
FDP, schwarz, rot,
so yellow is FDP, green, blue, pink. These are just the usual colors of the German parliament. And they're all in a sort of group together, except the AfD, which is removed.
Diese Färbung, und zwar als erstes die Fake News Verbreiter.
And now again, the fake news are colored, so we can see that the group that is close to AfD tends to be.
Der Witz ist, dass es nicht die AfD-Abgeordneten selber sind, die das Fake News verbreiten, aber sie befinden sich in einer gleichen.
Tends to be in the same group as those that are spreading the fake news. It isn't actually AfD members that are spreading this. Instead, it's new people that are not members of parliament, not members of AfD, but they're retweeted by the AfD.
Das restliche Twitter-Netzwerk für
and
verwendet.
Here we're trying to compare them with the with other Twitter users. So these are some words that are often used as compared to other Twitter users. Islam, Germany, migrants, Merkel, Maas, politics, fighting for liberty, refugees, SPD, etc. Now what we can see is that we actually have a very monothematic group. And what kind of group is this? So they're new on Twitter, they're close to the AfD, they often share fake news, they're very active on Twitter, and really they only care about migration and asylum politics.
Die erste Theorie, die man jetzt reinwerfen würde, das sind Social Bots. Und das in diesem
Vortrag geht, we're going to also talk about social bots next.
Ist der nächste Block, sich mal das Thema Social Bots genauer anzuschauen.
And we'll get it closer.
Wurde eine Menge veröffentlicht, auch in den Medien. Warum
this was published in the media at first, in other themes together, like democracy.
Jeder hat da irgendwie auch seine Meinung und seine Gefahr davon.
Everyone has their own opinion of what is exactly a social bot.
Aus dem Büro für Technikfolgenabschätzung beim Deutschen Bundestag.
Here from the German government we see an official statement of what it is. So
Programme, die uns irgendwie in den sozialen Medien manipulieren können.
There are bots that can communicate with on social media, but they're actually not people. They have automatic communication.
And then konkret, was diese Social Bots angeblich machen sollen können,
what these social bots can do,
ja, das heißt, normalerweise
they can actually,
ich interagiere mit,
it's a question if they pass a Turing test,
kann hinterher sagen, ob es ein Mensch oder ein Computer ist, und diese Social Bots sollen jetzt mal,
and then the Turing test is, can you tell if it's actually a social bot or is it an actual person?
Können nicht nur so tun, als wären sie ein Mensch, sondern sie können angeblich sogar noch unsere Meinung beeinflussen. Naja, zumindest hat der Bundestag veröffentlicht, Wirkung von Social Bots ist unter Sachverständigen strittig. Ich habe mal extra das vorgespult, wo Linus Neumann zu sehen ist.
Aber da ich hier so the German Parliament, they published that they don't really know what happens with Social Bots, what kind of reach they have.
Wenn ich Social Bots auf Twitter finden möchte, da muss ich sie erstmal suchen.
And if I want to find Social Bots on Twitter, I need to search them, and for that I need to know how they look.
Muss ich sie erstmal analysieren.
And for that, I need to analyze them.
Ja, also
sagen, so okay, we're kind of going in a circle.
Entweder eine Gruppe haben, um sie analysieren zu können.
I either need to need to have this group to analyze them, and then I can search for them.
Or
gibt I need to search for them to get this group and then analyze them. To get through this circle of terror, there's one way to go. And what we did is we bought social bots.
Das sind nicht wirklich Social Bots in dem engeren Sinne, sondern ich habe mir einfach 4.500 Bots gekauft.
Now, just as a clarification, they aren't actually social bots in a real sense, but I just bought 4.500 social bots.
Gesagt, damit ich also weiß, dass kein realer Mensch diesem Account folgt.
And I didn't tell anyone about that.
Genau. Und dann
so I just looked for Google,
und davon sind 100% Bots.
And I now have 4,500 followers, and 100% of those are bots.
Gucken, bestimmte, Eigenschaften, die
and this was just to see what kind of characteristics they have, and what would make them different from humans. So this is like a dry run. And then what we did is we tried to analyze the metadata. Now we have a graphic again. Each single point is one of these followers. So I have 4,500 points, and each of these are one bot. So I know there can't be a person in there. So I try to sort them according to whether they look like a person or a bot.
Dann habe ich einen Asus D5P23. Und habe unterschiedliche Eigenschaften.
On the left side, I have all of these characteristics of this one bot.
Ist, also ob er noch gar kein Avatarbild hochgeladen hat.
I looked, is he an egg? Does he not have an avatar yet? Does he have less than 10 followers? Does he have less than 50 favorites? Does he not have a description?
Für sich angegeben hat. Und ob er keine Zeitzone.
And if he has a time zone or not.
Die ganzen Metadaten, die man halt aus Twitter.
So this is the kind of metadata that you can get from Twitter.
Ob die sich denn irgendwie strukturieren und
gruppieren. To see whether we can actually group those boots.
Das sind so ein bisschen die sehr dummen Bots sind.
So on the left side we see the stupid bots. They don't really do anything. They're usually young.
Im breiten Bereich. Teilweise sehr realistisch.
Then there in the middle we have pretty realistic bots. Some of them are actually real accounts that are inactive.
Also aus irgendeinem Grund übernommen wurde.
Were taken over by bots.
Einer mal mit Passwort durchprobieren massenhaft versucht verweist.
I'm guessing someone just tried passwords and logged in that way.
Accounts, die teilweise sogar verifizierte Menschen.
The third are very interesting. They're accounts that are actually people, verified people. This author from the States. He's a survival specialist, Chris Glorioso,
is
an investigative reporter. These are real people that followed me because I paid them as bots.
Now
I tried sending them an email or a message, but not everyone answered because it seemed like their accounts were hijacked and they didn't know. I tried finding out how they were hijacked, but I didn't really find out.
Ging es dann aber weniger um politische Inhalte, sondern Zitat, es war eher Sexscheiße, die dann in ihren Twitter.
Most of the time when they were hijacked, it wasn't about political stuff, it was sex crap.
Kennzeichnung von Social Bots. Ja, was ist denn, wenn der eigene Account übernommen wurde?
What I find interesting, the CDU, they say that they want to mark each social bot. But what happens when these accounts are hijacked? Now what's interesting is looking at it 11 months later, which accounts are still active today? Yellow are the accounts that are that have been locked by Twitter. Red are those that somehow disappeared by themselves. So what we can do now is look at the follower networks of those bots. So I did this, the following graphic. There's 4,500 bots there, and you can see where they follow each other. Red are the bots, and blue are other users. And if we overlay it, we can see it looks quite interesting.
Fast wie ein fliegendes Spaghetti-Monster, fand ich.
Kind of like a flying spaghetti monster, I think.
Die blauen, das scheinen mir Jugendliche zu sein, die sich einfach.
The blue dots, they seem to be teenagers that actually just bought themselves those Twitter bots. And maybe it can be interesting to analyze them for me.
Bots oder Follower künstlich anzuhängen ist halt relativ einfach zu machen und ist auch gar nicht so teuer.
And you need to be careful. It's quite easy to go to actually just give 10,000 followers to someone, and it's not even very expensive. Now, what other ways are there to explain this? One way is to do a tweet apps analysis. Now, a couple years ago, maybe if you remember, for every tweet you could see which app it was used, it was published from.
The web interface no longer has this, but the API still does, and I can.
Twitter für iPhone.
I can run this over our bots.
Den Post als Tweet veröffentlichen und Instagram.
And it's mostly Twitter for iPhone, Twitter for Android, but also 350 additional services
Genau. Also es ist
they look like this, so it's a massive potpourri of things, Korean, Japanese, everything is in there.
Das war mir auch gar nicht so richtig klar vorher, dass es eigentlich ein riesiges, enormes Ökosystem gibt.
I didn't realize that there was this massive ecosystem of scripts that publish things on Twitter.
Und wie gesagt, halt in meiner Probe sind es allein 350.
In my study alone it's 350.
Was das denn jetzt eigentlich für Services sind, die dahinter stecken. To show
people what kind of services are behind this, I grabbed some of them. Here's Feedblitz.
Das ist eigentlich ein Bot, der nichts weiter macht, als ein RSS-Feed in Twitter zu posten.
Does nothing but post an RSS-Feed on Twitter.
That's twitbot.net.
Seems to be something.
Das hat sich wahrscheinlich einmal
homemade, but it
ein bisschen rumexperimentiert oder sowas.
Tweets nothing but rubbish.
There's the
Kim Kardashian Hollywood service that probably publishes the newest scores. There were 9 that were deleted and renamed to erased and a long string of numbers.
I'd
love to know if this number is sequential. Does it mean that 5 million apps have already been erased, or does it mean that 5 million have been registered with Twitter? But
Bots sind auch nicht nur böse. Ich habe mal ein paar rausgegriffen.
Bots are not.
Ich weiß nicht, ob jemand die Rathausuhr Neukölln kennt.
Always evil. I don't know if any of you know the
das
Town Hall Clock of Neukölln.
Also der veröffentlicht sowas wie achte Bam 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 Bam
He
Bam
publishes something like 8th bam 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 bam.
Vor kurzem bin ich übrigens auf den Wixer-Bot gestoßen, wenn man einen Tweet veröffentlicht, wo das Wort
Wixer
drin vorkommt, dann retweetet der ein.
Stumbled upon the Wixer-Bot, the Wanker-Bot.
Spiegel Online Top benutzt den Service if this then that.
Spiegel Online uses the service if this then that.
Spiegel Online Top. Und Zeit Online Digital and hat auch sich
Zeit Online, another German newspaper, built their own service. I don't know if they built it themselves or if they bought it, but it's registered as Zeit Online.
Woran könnte man jetzt nun Bots erkennen?
So to sum up, what, how could you detect a bot? You can check if the profile is fully filled out. You can check if it's part of a larger network. You check which app uses, which app sends the tweets, and you can look at the other metadata of the tweet.
But
all of these, none of these are conclusive.
Jegliche Bot-Erscheinungen könnte auch gut menschlich erklärt sein.
Oder andersrum, taken for themselves, each of them can be explained by human behavior, and the other way around. Of course, there might be a highly intelligent artificial intelligence behind this. But let's go and find some bots.
And to
make a long story short, I've found inactive accounts, service accounts, trolls, teenagers, racists and haters, and then spam with links to YouTube, porn or Bitcoin bullshit. But what I didn't find were politically active social bot networks. And this means that either they don't exist or I'm just stupid. So let's ask the professionals.
Davon ist zum Beispiel Professor Dr. Simon Hegelich.
One of them is Professor Dr. Simon Hegelich.
Political data science,
studies political data science using machine learning plus X.
Felddienstlimit plus X ist Alkohol? Nee, ich weiß nicht, keine Ahnung. Der veröffentlicht Studien zum Beispiel für die Konrad Adenauer.
He publishes studies for the Konrad Adenauer Foundation.
Leider wird in dieser Studie
with headlines like Invasion of the Opinion Robots, but he doesn't explain his own method. He did, however, write this study where they actually found bot networks in Ukraine and
unter einem Service Tweefarm pro-russische veröffentlicht haben. Insgesamt
found out that these bots used Tweefarm, which is an app that
das kann man, glaube ich, sagen, ein Bot-Netzwerk, was dort in der Ukraine gefunden wurde. Aber
well, this seems to be a bot-network that was used to post tweets in Ukraine, but what about Germany?
Gefunden, aber ich habe zumindest keine Studie von Professor Hegelich dazu gefunden.
Maybe I just didn't find it, but at least I couldn't find any study by Professor Simon Hegelich. I did find, however, this
Professor Simon Hegelich hatte hier die Aufgabe, aus Gigabyte an Daten Social Bots zu suchen.
This article from the German Public Broadcasting, where Mr. Hegelich found a potential candidate, Egon Dombrovski, who posts 136 posts per day with a clear tendency towards the right-wing AfD party.
And
the question is if this is a bot or real person. And the editorial staff sent him a message, and the potential social bot is called Egon Dombrovski, is 50 years old, is retired and lives in Erfurt. But he's very active in the AfD party. He calls media propaganda press,
and
he isn't paid by the AfD or anybody else. He just does this because of his own political views. So we try to find a political bot, and unfortunately we stumbled upon a real person. But there are other people who are trying to do this, like botswatch.de, who
zu gucken, wie viele sich auf Twitter nun Social Bots einmischen.
Twitter's and the involvement in Twitter's of Social Bots on Twitter during
important
events in Germany, and they link to an explanation of their method. And one of their criteria is 50 tweets per day, but Dombrovski makes it to 136 per day. And because we were looking at the German federal elections anyway, I made this long list of accounts that post things about the German federal election, and even the large parties, so the Christian Democratic parties, the
50 tweets am Tag,
the Liberal Party post more than 50 tweets per day. So if that's your criterion, you'd get a lot of media as well. You'd get politicians
like
Christopher Lauer or Anja Schillerneck from the Green Party in the Berlin House of Representatives. And of course the political parties, who are especially active in the campaign to the German federal elections. So 50 tweets per day as a criterion for social bots is simply not scientifically sound. They explain that this is one of the criteria that Oxford University uses. And I thought that looked interesting, and I read all the scientific papers on this subject. There's a lot of them, so I'll only show you two of them. Social bots during the US elections.
Das ist ein Paper, was veröffentlicht wurde.
This is a paper that was published with the title Bots and Automation on Twitter during the US election.
An welcher Stelle Sie das definieren?
And I go to the definition now.
Das ist also, Sie fangen halt an, von Social Bots zu reden. Dann heißt es Social Bot Like.
Und dann they start talking about social bots, and then they say like social bots, heavy automated bots, and then they say we define a high level of automation of as accounts that post at least 50 times a day using one of these election-related hashtags. So if you publish a tweet with a special hashtag more than 50 times a day. These are the hashtags that they used. The first is Trump, the second is Clinton, and the third is general election hashtags.
Aber zu dieser Definition von Social Bots habe ich mal ein paar Fragen.
But I have a couple of questions for this definition of social bots. Why 50 and not 30 or 100 per day? And is that the same for every country? Can we use this criterion for Germany? And what account are these actually? If I can identify those, then I can look at them in particular. What are the characteristics? How many followers do they have? How many favs? How many retweets do they have? Maybe no one even reads them. And what services are they using to post? You saw that we can actually see that. And of course, I can see that there's a lot of accounts, but there's a scientific method to just take a sample, a random sample. Did the scientists actually do that? There's no study that actually says whether anyone actually did this sample. Unfortunately, I can't check that because the University of Oxford hasn't published the data. Partly that's because of the developer API of Twitter. But you can actually do that.
Und kann sich dann sozusagen nachträglich den Tweet nochmal holen und genauer analysieren. Zum Glück gibt es von der George Washington
Universität Luckily, the George Washington University has published a paper on 2016 United States presidential election tweet IDs. And this is mostly about tweets that have the hashtag election day. Unfortunately, I don't have the same data as the University of Oxford, but I can use this data, which is a small sample from the University of Oxford data. That is those that use election day hashtag on the day of election.
Diejenigen, die sogar mehr als 100 Mal am Wahltag getwittert haben, sind diese 12.
And those 12 actually published, tweeted more than 100 times on election day. And those would be the ones that are most significantly seen as social bots.
Wer denn jetzt diese Social Bots wirklich sind, and nehmen wir uns mal Zeit und gucken uns jeden einzelnen.
Then we looked at each of these 12 potential bots.
Dream of Dust, der 437 Tweets am Wahltag.
The first is Dream of Dust. He published 437 tweets on election day. He twitters links to reddit.com/r/thedonald and uses IFTTT.
Auf jeden Fall.
And we can see that he definitely is a bot. Because he actually just uses published comments on Reddit to put them on Twitter, but actually there's no influence that he actually exerts, or almost no influence. ITX News twitters screenshots of texts, very, very strange conspiracy theories, very strange.
Und er benutzt für seine Screenshots, die er dann veröffentlicht, immer die aktuellen Hashtags.
Screenshots that he publishes, he uses the trending hashtags. Has 4 followers
und er ist ganz klar kein Bot.
And is not a bot.
Der nächste Account.
Next account.
Trump supporter,
Joseph, a Trump supporter, because he thinks Clinton is
hashtags,
terrible.
Lebt auf Hawaii,
uses hashtags intensively.
Das sieht man an den Zeiten meiner
sleeps Twitter. For 6 hours a day.
Und er ist auf jeden Fall kein Bot.
Takes a break during lunch
der
and is not a bot.
Liebt er Bernie Sanders.
Next one. Loves Bernie Sanders. Hates Donald Trump, Hillary Clinton, the Democrats, Bill and Chelsea Clinton, and Expedia.
Weil Chelsea Clinton jetzt im Board sitzt.
Oh, because Chelsea Clinton is on the board. But he's not a bot.
Der nächste, der sieht mir doch sehr fischig aus.
The next one looks kind of fishy to me. I think it's a Spanish-speaking click farm that tries to get users to click on web on advertising sites. For apps or something like that. There's no political stuff there, and it just uses trending hashtags. To just get its links out better. Has one follower. I don't think it's a bot, because there's a couple of mistakes, spelling mistakes, so the programming would be really bad if it was a bot. But there's no impact there. Now we'll go to the more interesting cases. Hurley, she's a grandma from Brooklyn.
Und hat vor kurzem mit dem Rauchen aufgehört.
She recently stopped smoking. So
an dem Wahltag hat sie wie wild
she
Trump getwittert.
Tweeted for Trump.
Und hat versucht, Leute
very enthusiastically. She's not a bot.
Dann habe ich hier noch den hier. Der ist aus Tokio. Ich vermute, es ist ein Student.
A student probably from Tokio who tweets
so
in Japanese. And then this was kind of the moment where I was lost in translation, because I have no idea what he was trying to say. But I assume that he hates Toru Hashimoto and Kazuma Yiri. One of them is a politician. The other is an internet entrepreneur. And he just used the current trending hashtag. Not a bot either, actually.
Der nächste, Paolo.
Next guy, Paolo.
Paolo kann 13 Tweets in 3 Sekunden schicken.
He can send 13 tweets in 3 seconds. There's clapping now.
Er nutzt dafür drei unbekannte italienische Twitter-Services.
Uses three not really known Italian Twitter services. One of them is apparently
Tweets werden so gut wie gar locked
at this point. He's pro Hillary. There's no favs or retweeting. He is a bot, but there's very little influence that he actually exerts over anything. And this one, he loves Jesus, family, Trump, WikiLeaks, Fox News and weapons.
Hasst Abtreibung, Feminismus,
hates, Clinton, CNN, abortion, Obamacare. Feminism, Hillary Clinton, CNN, Obamacare.
Aber ein Bot ist es nicht.
Not a bot.
Dann haben wir noch President Trump.
Then we have President Trump.
Der ist ein Satire-Account.
It's a satire-Account.
Teilweise witzig, hat trotzdem nur einen Follower.
Sometimes funny, but he only has one follower anyway.
Aber ein Bot ist es auch
and
nicht.
And it's not a bot either.
Dann haben wir noch Mareike. Sie ist Journalistin aus Südafrika.
And we have Mareike. She's a journalist from South Africa. She works for the French press agency AFP. And tweeted live about election day on the day.
Not a bot either.
Dr. Van Nostrum. We didn't find a picture. He loves baseball, American football, Fox News, Trump. Hates Hillary, Bill Clinton, CNN, Islam, feminist links. Everything on the left side of the spectrum. He followed Trump's win live on Twitter.
Den Wahltag intensiv verfolgt und begleitet, aber ein Bot ist er auch nicht.
Is not a bot either.
So, und das war jetzt der 12. von den 12.
And that was the 12th of those 12 that according to this criterion would be bots.
Pro Clinton, neutral,
so I did this table.
Und zeilenweise
pro Clinton, neutral, pro Trump, human, unsure and social bot.
Wir haben auf jeden Fall einen Social Bot gefunden, der pro Clinton ist. Und
so we found one Social Bot pro Clinton, one pro Trump.
Ob es sich tatsächlich um einen Social Bot handelt, wäre ich sehr vorsichtig, denn sie haben ja keine soziale Interaktion bewiesen.
But they didn't really have social interaction, which means we can't really call them social bots.
Und hatten auch dabei nicht wirklich einen Impact.
And they didn't really have an impact, because no one actually retweeted them or cared about what they tweeted.
Waren pro Trump
There's a
Menschen,
large group of pro-Trump humans.
Auf der pro-Clinton-Seite haben wir nur einen Satire-Account gefunden.
There was only one pro-Clinton satire-Account in the human.
Bernie Sanders-Fan, eine Journalistin.
And in the neutral, we had some people that were neutral regarding the election.
Dann haben wir noch hier unsure, derjenige, der seine Links zu App-Werbeseiten.
And then we're unsure about the person that has this link farm.
Ich glaube, dass sie an einer politischen Diskussion teilgenommen haben. Sind das die hier? Und das sind alles Menschen.
So everyone who actually participated in a political discussion was actually a human. Clapping again.
Die Studie Bots and Automation over Twitter during US location US election müsste eigentlich heißen highly active
so
Twitter users.
So what they should actually call it was not bots and automation over Twitter during US election, but instead highly active humans during the Twitter election. Social bots are politically active people, hashtag spam, some very simple bots that can't really called that can't really be called social, and media and journalists.
Und da gibt's von der University of South Carolina.
I tried finding another study that used a different definition.
The 2016 US presidential election online discussion.
Social bots distort the 2016 US presidential election online discussion.
Ein, service, der nennt sich Bot or Not.
And they use a service. They are called Bot or Not or Botometer now.
Nicht zu tief, einsteigen,
to identify whether there's whether it's a social bot or not. So what they do is very similar to what I did at the beginning. They use all the metadata to categorize an account.
Mit einer Wahrscheinlichkeit abzuschätzen.
And then they try to find a probability for whether an account is a bot or not. And that's the basis for the study. There's a link for this, in case you want to play with it a little bit.
Twitter-Account autorisieren.
Now be careful, you need to authorize your Twitter account.
Sondern er möchte auch Schreibrechte haben.
And he also wants rights.
Ich habe einfach mal ein paar
Write permission on
um zu
Twitter.
Gucken, wie vertrauenswürdig das ist. Da habe ich jetzt hier einfach mal.
I put a couple bots in there just to have an idea of whether we can trust this.
Das Kriterium übrigens der Studie ist 50%. Alle die unter 50%.
The criterion is 50%. Everyone less than 50% is a human. Over 50% is a person.
Das Bundesministerium für Justiz und Verbraucherschutz 55%. Das BKA ist ein Social Bot.
Now, as you can see, all of these big ministries are actually social bots, whereas those bots that we have identified, they're not bots, according to this criterion.
But maybe this is just because the ones we looked at were tweeting in German, but no, even the American president would be considered a bot under these criteria.
Das könnt ihr auch alles selber ausprobieren.
And you can try all this for yourselves. So scientifically, none of this is tenable. And
erwartet keine große Gefahr durch Social Bots im Wahlkampf.
If you're not convinced, then well, Hegelich does not expect any social bot interaction during election day.
Social Bots, Filterblasen, Fake News.
Social Bots, Filter Bubbles and Fake News. To say it carefully. The research is still at the very beginning. We still need to develop and check our methodologies, and we need to review scientific publications. So if any of you are doing your own research on this, then I would like to ask you to check these scientific studies.
In den Diskursen
in the
die Leute als Nazis,
Discourse,
sozial abgehängt, Mittelschicht,
we called people Nazis, socially detached, and now newly as social bots. But what these people have in common is they're scared and they're angry and they do not believe in social institutions.
Und sie nutzen ihr Recht und die
and
Möglichkeit,
new groups are entering social networks and they're using their right to free speech and they even take recourse to fake news if this aligns with their own opinions.
Vielleicht gibt es irgendwann eine technische Lösung. Wer weiß.
Maybe we will someday have a technological solution, but maybe we should also rely on media literacy to develop a culture of debate. This is a new research field. We're seeing a new science develop. Maybe it's still very small now, but it's undergoing a fundamental shift
towards
a science that tries to find rules, to find laws, and to produce reproducible results, like we know from the natural sciences.
Die Astrologie, das war die Lehre von den Sternen, bis dann das Teleskop erfunden wurde.
We saw something similar with astrology, which was the law of stars, and then we developed telescopes and could actually observe the stars, and then astrology became astronomy. And the debates that we have in and about social networks could turn into a science that looks at social networks, and I think this is not only possible, but also necessary. At least we need to do a lot of research, and I would like to encourage all of you who aren't sure if they want to work in political science or in data science to combine the two. Bachelor and master's programs are very suited to reproducing these studies and to try to validate these studies. And I would like to support this and to find time to publish parts of my frameworks and parts of my data over the course of the next 2.5 days. You can also reach me under DECT3600 or on Twitter at Michael Kreil. I would love to connect people who are doing their own research on this and to see if we can't start a scientific debate on this subject.
Mindestens das will ich nachher nochmal hören. Jetzt haben wir noch etwas über eine Viertelstunde Zeit für Fragen und Antworten. Habt ihr Fragen?
Now we have roughly quarter of an hour for questions and answers.
Einigermaßen
please go to the microphones.
Ausgeglichen,
and I'll try to be fair.
Steht schon irgendwo jemand? Hebt mal die Hand. Ah, da hinten. Mikrofon 4.
When choosing, an. So microphone 4 is up now.
Ich habe eine Frage bezüglich so state-sponsored Propaganda.
I have a question regarding state-sponsored propaganda.
Bezahlt werden.
So people that are paid by states or governments to do this propaganda. Have you seen that or have you looked at that?
Leute zu finden, die an den Bots, die in den
We've searched for such people.
Teilnehmen. Ob sie jetzt tatsächlich dafür bezahlt werden
oder and nicht. Look for the bots if they're actually being paid or not.
Wir sehen aber, wenn jetzt zum Beispiel jemand bei der
US-Wahl, we're seeing, for example, by the US election,
in den nächsten Monaten bis heute noch
from the last months until today,
in den sozialen Netzwerken
that they really live off the social networks, including Facebook.
So it doesn't look like it's actually paid people. The question that I'm asking is, even if someone pays, what's the impact?
Soziale Interaktion Leute davon überzeugen.
Can I actually convince people to change their political opinions on Twitter by paying them or by influencing them by paying someone else?
Mikro 2.
Vielen Dank für den großartigen Vortrag.
Thank you for the great presentation.
Super wichtig.
I find it very important.
Und eigentlich sehen, dass ich wirklich an wissenschaftlichen Methodiken verändern muss.
And I see that we really need to change the type of methods we're doing for the research behind it.
Weil offensichtlich spiegeln diese Nachrichten ja nur was.
And I have a question that how do we actually have, how does the reach actually change, and how do we know how the reach impacts and how it's impacting people.
Auf jeden Fall. Wir haben auch zum Beispiel gesehen,
definitely, we should find a new word. We shouldn't call everything fake news. We see that a lot of this fake news comes from a town in Eastern Europe, and they don't even have a political agenda. They just like people to click them, and they get money from clicking.
Gar kein politisches Ziel dahinter.
And there's no political goal behind that.
Probiert, aber das hat einfach nicht so gut eingeschlagen. Pro Trump Sachen.
They tried pro Clinton first and then they switched to Trump because they made more money with it. So that's why I think fake news is kind of wrong.
Ja, zuerst auch aus dem
We have a question from the internet.
Vortrag. Es wurde angemerkt, es sehr sehr interessant, den Hashtag 34C3 zu analysieren und Trolle aufzudecken.
And we're talking about trolls hashtag.
It would be interesting to look at 34C3 and look whether there's bots or someone who's just trolling on there. Do we see bot wars soon? Is there anything known about this situation?
Flame bots.
Also das sind alles theoretische.
It's all theoretical. They're theoretical concepts now. When the studies are read through, that it could be true.
Und sage, sowas wird nie passieren oder sowas.
I can't stand here and say it doesn't come to fruition. We have to see what happens in the next days.
Aber das, was wir jetzt bisher sehen konnten.
But until now, what we've seen.
Die durchs Internet laufen.
That there's could be chaos through it.
Servus. Ja,
wunderbar, funktioniert. Das erste harte Kriterium, das mir einfallen würde, um Bot-Accounts von
Menschen. The first hard criterion I could think of to distinguish posts from bots would be the frequency of posting.
Nur einmal auffällig war.
And you only chose that one. Why?
Die anderen Accounts. Also ich meine, wenn ich jetzt
so Bot, when I'm developing a social bot,
haut er jetzt nicht alle halbe Sekunde einen Tweet raus.
And it sends something every half a second, a tweet.
Aber in diesem Fall ist es
nur
einmal aufgetreten, dass ein Bot sozusagen den
Bug hat. In this case, it only appeared once that this bot had this bug, and I would consider it a bug, because if I was developing something, I wouldn't, I would make sure that the bot doesn't publish tweets as often.
Next question is, does that mean that the social bots actually lost the influence? And that, how's connected to filter bubbles?
Ob das sich dann verliert oder ob du in den Forschungen gesehen hast,
and have you seen in the research,
da ist, wie sie irgendwie überall propagiert wird?
Does it propagate further?
Also, zum einen, ich glaube, es gibt so einen Satz, den man in den letzten 10 Jahren immer wieder gehört
hat.
Internet ist nicht an bestimmten Sachen schuld.
One sentence that we've heard again is that the Internet, it's not the Internet's fault. The Internet just makes things visible again. And I think there's a lot of people that would like to participate at a political discourse, and they couldn't before, but now they can actually participate in this discourse.
Is there a danger
of social bots sind unwirksam so wirklich, ob das nicht dann
sich all I want, the question is being repeated again, which wants to ask whether the social bots are not as much of a danger as is said, because you've shown that most of them are not social bots, and that the social bots don't actually are active in discourse. So the answer is that he can't really say it, because we don't really know where it's going at this point.
Ja, man darf ja auch nicht vergessen, das ist eine extrem experimentelle Technologie.
And this is still experimental technology.
Weltübergreifend.
And the world network, the Internet, is still kind of experimental technology. So we don't know what happens.
Hallo. Erstmal ein Kompliment für diesen super.
First of all, a compliment for this really important presentation. My question then is, because you were talking about Twitter,
and auch Verbreitung haben.
How do they actually influence the impact of how far the reach is impacting? The question is, when a tweet is published, when they do have 10,000 followers, that's then more important than one follower, obviously.
You can think of metrics to figure that out. And usually, I don't look at tweets that aren't retweeted at all. But I don't know if there's actually a good metric that you can use that would classify different numbers of followers. The other thing is other social networks. You see what happens on YouTube is that a lot of people that they record their opinion on YouTube, and there's a Russian network as well.
Genau, da gibt's V-Kontakte, genau. Da gibt es auch,
which is called V-Contacts. And I know someone who actually looked at that. But the big thing that people look at is Facebook. And Facebook has two problems. First of all, there's a lot of closed groups where everything happens. I looked into them, and it wasn't very different from the public stuff. And the second problem is that the API is not very public. I think Facebook actually has a lot of data material to do this research, but unfortunately it's all within the company and they don't share it.
A social bot has a question.
Neil lässt fragen, gibt es Studien für das reale Ausmaß und den realen Impact von Fake News in den sozialen Medien und wo
about the effect of fake news in the media?
Angezogen.
Habe ich akustisch nicht verstanden.
They didn't answer that question.
Das reale Ausmaß von Fake News und wurden die herangezogen zur Legitimisierung des NetzDGs?
Is it the legitimation of the network and the impact of the fake news?
Aus meiner Erfahrung würde ich sagen, sie haben keinen Einfluss, weil sie halt erstmal nicht Leute.
I think they don't really have an influence because people they go into these networks with their opinions already set, and then they just get this basically reinforced. I think there's a little bit of an influence of people that have some sort of latent tendencies already, and then they go into this filter bubble and they find all these other people that have the same opinions. And I think that, for example, crimes against refugees are partly motivated by this.
Bisschen mehr Dampf.
Okay, danke für den Vortrag.
Du thank you for the presentation.
Karte, wo
you had this first nice picture that showed that the AfD political party was connected to the fake news? And how do you know that these tweets were actually fake news?
So what I did is I chose fake news and looked at who shares them. I chose stories that I knew that were fake news, and then I looked at who shared them on Twitter. This is the direction I went at it.
Mikro 3.
Ja, ich habe noch eine Frage.
I have one question.
Antworten. Also quasi, also ich habe oft gehört von Journalisten, die sich beschwert haben,
wenn sie heard from journalists
berichtet haben, dass da irgendwelche Bots sie jetzt mit Antworten zumüllen oder sowas. Hast du sowas beobachten können?
Have you actually observed that the bots from journalists
that bots actually reply? So a lot of journalists that I've talked to told me that they have the problem of getting a lot of replies from bots. The answer is that I'm not saying that all the everyone on Twitter is actually a real person, and if I can actually use a bot to make a hashtag unusable, but that way I can just destroy this hashtag. It's not really an influence that I can exert actually on people. Regarding journalists,
auf Twitter aktiv sind und dann immer wieder mit großen
I know a couple of
Accounts konfrontiert werden.
People that are active on Twitter and get lots of accounts, but I don't know if it's bots or if it's the same.
Unterschiedlich sind, ne? Das ist schon ein relativ hartes Problem.
And it's quite difficult to actually get a lot of different tweets with an artificial intelligence.
Ja, eine Frage zu einem Kriterium.
A question about one of the criteria.
Aufgetaucht ist oder nicht, oder ob ich nur nicht aufmerksam genug war.
How is the attention? Was it enough?
Gleichlautende Nachrichten in Tweets zum Beispiel. Also ich weiß, dass
and how does it compare to the concurrent tweets from the news?
Und auch manuell sozusagen.
And how is this manually composed?
Wie gesagt, ein Einflussfaktor.
And how do you analyze the impact factor?
Spielt das in den Studien irgendeine Rolle?
Is this a role that's being played in the studies?
Für deine Arbeit?
For your work?
In den Studien kann ich nicht sagen, weil die hatten jetzt immer nur ihre Kriterien.
In the studies, they really only used their criteria with the hashtags and the number of tweets.
Aufgefallen ist, dass es immer wieder.
In my work, I saw that.
Natürlich Leute, die sagen, okay, ich will
nicht retweeten,
sondern ich kopiere den.
There's some people that don't want to retweet, but instead they copy a tweet.
Formulierungen, die zu
Zehntausenden. And there's some ways of phrasing things that come up and come up and come up. And this is kind of like text data that is played again and again, but usually this isn't political content.
Keinerlei politische Aktivität zu sehen. Und die zwei, bitte.
Ja, hallo und auch nochmal vielen Dank für den Vortrag.
Also again, thank you again for the presentation. A question about the theme of the travel warning in Sweden. How much work did you have to find out which tweets were hearing about this, and how did you find out about it?
The
answer is we looked at how many accounts were actually deleting the tweets, and then we later looked at it in the meantime were actually deleted. I'm not sure that I found all of the tweets about this, but I did look for everything that was related to traveling to Sweden, and also what was connected to others. And so we looked further and further into all of the related topics. Then I had 1,800 tweets, and then categorized them all by hand if they were fake news. So that was my method. So
it
was half automated hand, I would say, personally done.
Die Eins ist das, bitte.
Hallo, hallo.
Now,
I have
one short question. And one plead for further data. One, how much of your raw data can you publish? And second, your example with the Twitter timeline with 2,000 tweets.
Ich habe mehr ungelesene Mails in meine Inbox.
And that's a size that you often see in this debate. But I actually have more than 2,000 unread tweets in my mailbox. So why is it relevant?
Es gibt tatsächlich eine Guideline von Twitter, die
ist guideline from Twitter that's
von einem bestimmten Account zehntausende von Tweets zu veröffentlichen.
It's not allowed actually to publish so many like 10,000 tweets.
Jetzt einfach mal so rechtsklick veröffentlichen gemacht. Ich würde das mir nochmal genauer angucken, was
but
ich
I have to look more closely.
Gerade high-rated tweets heißt das, also sozusagen.
This high-rated tweets is the name of this concept.
Oder sowas, die man dann sich in Excel mal durchklicken kann.
We can look through and click through the data.
Either
from one or the others. This new data should help us, and we have to look in the next couple of days. For this 2,000 accounts, if it has an impact or not, was the second part of the question. The context is this too much, or is this a large amount or not? So I intuitively think 2,000 followers is not actually so much if we're talking about a population of millions of people. This is a classical argument.
Dann sind eine Menge Leute in Facebook, ist es nur ein winzig kleiner Teil davon auf Twitter.
So if you look at the followers of Facebook, then it's really a tiny impact or a tiny amount of followers.
But I have to say, in den sozialen Netzwerken sind aber die
in social networks, activists and journalists, they do have influence. Actually,
also die Twitter-Diskussion halte ich
Twitter-Discussion
für gesellschaftlich relevant.
Twitter is actually not politically relevant.
So, last question.
Erst kurz danke, weil dein Projekt mir im Studium mich ziemlich gerettet hat. Also danke.
Thanks, because your project actually saved me when studying.
Ist mir halt aufgefallen, gerade bei diesen Troll-Army.
And then what I found was that, especially in this trolling army,
in den Accounts, wie oft sich bestimmte
if you looked at whether there's certain repetitions within these accounts, for example, there's often the same profile picture and accounts with consecutive numbers, when the first one deletes.
We're seeing this generally,
and then seeing if an account of Twitter is canceled and then it comes back later. We're seeing if it's being paid for. If it's actually paid for or not, it doesn't come from the Twitter API. We actually have to then look with to the people and talk to them and see if that's... But then that's also dangerous to answer. Is this actually criminally organized or if it's artificial intelligence behind it? It's naturally something we need to research.
Ich habe die auch nur zufällig gefunden.
Ah, okay.
Weil ich so
I only found them by accident, actually.
Damals zur Türkei-Wahl.
Because I looked at it for the election in Turkey, and there were a lot of accounts that posted Turkish spam, and then suddenly in very bad German they went into German debate.
Of course.
Then
we can talk later, of course.
Vielen Dank, Michael Kreil.
Thank you, everyone, for listening. Thank you, Michael Kreil.